Well, let's also tell you about the latest they're coming in where, at a time where the people are questioning the BMC over its lack of preparedness in dealing with the rains. The flooding of Mumbai's Mithi River, in fact, continues to be a worry for the civic officials. That is what we're given to understand. And on the night of the 1st July, the river overflowed across the entire length of 18 kilometers. The center, the BMC and the MMRDA together have spent over 2,000 crore rupees in 15 years to widen and deepen the river so that the flood less this monsoon. So why is it that the Mithi River is still a challenge? Let me go across to my colleague Avni, who is joining me live to understand the situation better. Avni, of course, let's also understand that the BMC has been claiming that 90% of its work when it comes to widening and the desilting of the Mithi River has been completed. This has been one of their tall claims. Then why is it that right now we're discussing how the Mithi River has breached the danger mark? It is overflowing. It is causing a lot of problems despite having a huge sum allocated for its maintenance.
Absolutely, Apurva. Like you pointed out, the Mithi River has been a problem ever since, in fact, 2005, when we saw that deluge and the floods in Mumbai. The Mithi River really overflowed then. And since then, there has been work going on to try and bring that under control. But obviously, that's not really happening as we saw this time round. So just for our viewers to put it a little bit into context, if the Mithi River and its surrounding areas is what really gets, we'll just zoom into the map for you in just a minute. So that's really the Mithi River. It originates up near the Sanjay Gandhi National Park in the hills there and flows down for about 18 odd kilometers before draining off into the Mahim Bay and then, of course, into the Arabian Sea. So all the surrounding areas of Mithi River are the ones which always get flooded. So that includes areas such as Marol, Andheri East, Kurla, Sakinaka, and all these are heavily prone to floods, in fact. So the problem really here is that there are half a dozen nalas which really flow into the Mithi River. The river receives as much as 300 million liters of sewage daily, and a lot of that sewage is solid. So what happens is that river is not really able to take that load, and it starts seeping out into the surrounding areas as it's flowing down because of all the solid waste that the river really sees. And that's really the problem, and what's made the situation worse is that encroachments along the banks of the river have also caused the river to really narrow. And remember, the Mithi River is actually one of the city's oldest and natural stormwater drains. And this is now it's become nothing more than just a pile of sewage that keeps flowing down and causing a lot of other issues other than overflowing. It causes, of course, a lot of problems for the people who are living in the surrounding areas. Now, like Apurva was pointing out, there has been a lot of money that has been put in for the last 15 years. Work has been going on. 2,000 crore odd rupees has already been put in is what we're given to understand. BMC says that 90% of the work of widening the river and desilting is all of that has been completed. But obviously, that doesn't seem to be the case when we see what's really happening on ground. So the question here that we have to ask is that where has the money gone? And if for 15 years this work has been going on, why is this still such an issue? So those are some really important questions that we have to ask as far as the Mithi River is concerned, because this is a problem area that has been on. Every time it rains, the water gets it gets flooded, the sewage starts coming out, the water starts coming out, and it affects all the people who are living in the surrounding areas of the Mithi River, Apurva.
Absolutely, and it is also very concerning, Avni, as you're pointing out, because the IMD has also said that the forecast clearly claims that another 2 days of heavy downpour is what the Mumbaikars are going to be looked at, and the fact that Mithi River has already crossed the danger mark should be extremely alarming for the officials. But for the moment, Avni, many thanks for joining us and giving us a sense of why Mithi River floods every year and where is the problem.